Students, today we will see the next part of our
scholarship syllabus,
that is even numbers. Okay, even and odd numbers, and how the examples are coming related to even and odd numbers, that we are going to study in this lecture. So first of all, we will see the even numbers. As you know that it is very easy to identify the even numbers. Just we have to check the numbers 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. These numbers 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. If it is present at its unit place, then the number is called as an even number. For example, here some examples I wrote it here. 238, 780, 524, 2856, 202. If you see these numbers, at its unit place, which number is here? 8 is here. Here it is 0. Here it is 4, 6, and here 2. So these numbers are present. Means all numbers here. 2, 2 2's are 4, 2 3's are 6, 2 4's are 8, and 0. If these numbers are present in the unit place of a number, that is very important. Which place? Unit place of a number. Then those numbers are called as a which numbers? Even numbers. Now I will write some examples. You will understand. Okay. So here it is. I will write 2, 4, 3, 1. Is it even or odd? Yes. Is it even or odd? So to check it, we have to check only the place. Which place? Unit place of a number. In this number inside, 1 is at unit place. You know the place values I told you. It is unit place, tens place, hundred place, and this one is the thousands place. So we have to check only the unit place of a number, and here at unit place which number is there? 1 is there. And what I told you, the numbers which 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, if it is present at unit place, then the number is a even number. So here which number is present here? 1 is at unit place. So these number 0, 2, 4, 6, 8 is not here. So this number is not a even number. Understood? So one more example we will see. 2, 4, 6, 5. Any number, any number, how many it is, it may be any places are there, how many places. So here I will write here this 6. You have to check only the last digit of a number. If it is 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, from this any one number is here, then it is even number. And here it is 6 is there, that's why this number is a even number. Okay, now the next is the odd numbers. So the even number inside which number is, so as we know that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 0 means tens place 0. These digits are there. Okay. From these digits, the numbers which are present in 2's table, for example 2, 4, 6, 8 and 0. If these numbers are at unit place, then the given number is called as a even number. And the numbers which this 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. These odd numbers are present at unit place. These numbers present, then it is called as a odd numbers. Now here definition I wrote it here. Numbers which have any of the digit which is 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. Is at which place? Same, that is unit place. Then the given number is called as a odd number. Now if you see here numbers, I gave you example some 3, here it is 9, here it is 7, 1 and here it is 5. So these numbers are present at the unit place, and these numbers are which 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, these numbers are here, that's why these all numbers are the odd numbers. Okay, now after that what we will see? First of all, we will identify that is it odd or is it even number. So how to identify? First of all, this I will write it here, then it will be clear for you. So here I will write one number 2, 5, 3, 1. You have to check the unit place. 1 is here. So as per definition just now I told you 1, 3, 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. If it is present at which place? Unit place. Then that number is a odd number. And 2, 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. If it is present at which place? unit place, then number is called as a even number. So first of all, you check the unit place number, that is here 1. 1 is present at unit place, that's why this number is a odd number. Understand what I said? You have to check the only which place of a number, that is unit place of a number. Now I will take one more example here. So 4, 5, 2, 0, check unit place, 0 is there. 0 is where coming? In the even numbers place. So this is even number. Again, if it is, I will write here 3, 5, 9, 7, check the unit place of a number, what is here? 7. 7 is present in the odd number, that's why this given number is a odd number. Okay, again 5, 2, 1, 6, unit place which number is there? 6 is present at unit place, and that's why the given number is even number, because if 6 is present at unit place, the given number is a even number. Okay, again suppose here I will write, in this way we have to identify the even and odd numbers. So first of all, let us understand how many even numbers and how many odd numbers are present in the one digit. As you know that how many one digit numbers are there, the numbers that is from 0 to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. These are the numbers present. These are the which numbers? One digit number. Okay, total how many numbers are there? 9 are there. From these numbers, 2, 4, 6, 8. These 4 numbers are even numbers. So how many even numbers are there in one digit? How many even numbers are there? 4. And which is the smallest one from this? One digit smallest even number is 2. These types of question. What is the sum of smallest one digit to even number and smallest two digit even number? In this way, the such a type of questions are also coming in the exam. So first of all, let's understand. So 2 is the smallest even number and 8 is the greatest even one digit even number. After that, 1, 3, 5, 7, and 9. Total how many numbers are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. 5 odd numbers are there. Means the total numbers, total one digit numbers are 9 are there. From that 9 number, 5 are even and 4 are even and 5 are odd. So total how many numbers are there? How many? 9. Now regarding to the two digit numbers, actually if you count, then two digit numbers are starting from the smallest two digit number is the 10 and greatest two digit number is 99. So total how many numbers are present in this, in between them? That is 90 numbers are present in between 10 and 99. So out of this, 45 are, means out of 90 numbers, 45 are odd and 45 are even numbers. Okay, so that you have to keep in your mind, that 45 are odd and 45 are the even number. Like same 3 digit numbers, which is the smallest 3 digit number? Yes, it is 100. Total so 100 number is there, and greatest 3 digit number is 999. So in between 199, total how many numbers are there? Total 900 numbers are present in between 100 and 99, and out of these 900 numbers, 450 are even and 450 are odd numbers. Okay, so in this way, and smallest 3 digit even number is 100 and smallest 3 digit odd number is 101, because 100 is even and next of it is the which is, that is 101 is the smallest odd number. Next, greatest odd number. This 999 is the greatest odd number. If you are taking the next number of 999, the number is 1000. Okay, and 1000 how many digits are there? 1, 2, 3 and 4 digits are there. That's why it is not a 3 digit number. So 9, the number which is behind 999 is 998. So it is the smallest even number. Okay, in this way, these things you know, then it is easy for you to solve the examples. Now we will see the next first 4 digit numbers. So which is the first 4 digit number? That is 1000 is the first 4 digit number, and greatest 4 digit is number is the 9999, and in between them how many total numbers are there? That is 9,000 numbers are there in between them. And out of this 9,000, 4,500 are even and 4,500 are odd numbers. So if total numbers are there, half of it is a even and half of it is a odd. So in this way, how it is there? For that I will tell you one example. If I will write 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. So in this, 1 is odd, 2 is even, 3 is odd, 4 is even, 5 is odd, 6 is even, 7 odd, 8 is even, 9 is odd and 10 is even. If you see here 10 numbers, the correct sign I had done, these are the which numbers? Odd numbers and circle numbers are the even. In this way, how many numbers you are taking? Half of it is even and half numbers are odd numbers are there. Okay, clear this point? Now we will see some of the questions based on this number. So what is the question given here? P is a odd number. P is a odd number. And what will be the next fifth odd number? What will be the next fifth odd number? So how to find out this? First of all, I will understand. Here P is which type of number they told you? It is odd number. And we have to find out next which number? Odd number only. Odd is number is there. And next odd number if you want to find out. So at that time what we have to, just now we seen that one odd, one even numbers are there. So next fifth odd number they are asking to us. Next fifth odd number. So first is the one number, first P is the number. And as you know that 5 numbers are there. So suppose here P plus 1, then P plus 2, P plus 3. In this way if we are adding these numbers, then what happens? 1 odd and 1 even numbers are coming. So total here, what if you want to find out the fifth odd number, so fifth double we have to do. Fifth double is 10. Okay. If they are asking to you which is the next fifth odd number, then this it is fifth P plus 10. So second is the option. If they are asking the fifth number previous to the X P, which is the fifth odd number previous to the P, at that time which number will come here? Only this we have to do the subtraction, because previous number we have to find out, then we have to write it, do the subtraction of it, and next number, for next number we have to do the addition of these numbers. Okay, now again which questions are coming? Suppose this is a fifth odd number. Now suppose here odd number is given and odd number only asking to us. So suppose here P is a, suppose question is different. Suppose P is a odd number and we have to find out the next odd number of it. Next odd number of it. So how to find out it? So as you know that 2 is counted there, 1 then 3 is there, and 3 minus 1 is equal to 2. Okay, so we have to, once they are asking next odd number we have to add 2, next second odd number 4 we have to write, 5th 10 we have to add, 8th number if they are asking then we have to add, it's a double. If odd is number is there and we have to find out the next even number, we have to find out the next even number at that time. So if P is a odd number and we have to find out next fifth only we will take, fifth even number, otherwise we will take eighth even number. So at that time what we have to do? First of all we have to P plus eighth double we have to do here. First even and odd, we am telling here odd and even different came, even is there. If odd is there, that time what I told you which number they are asking is double we have to do. 5 is double 10 and we have to add in it. Next is the next number, you have to add. Previous number, you have to subtract. Now, if one number is odd number and they are asking the next odd number, so at that time what we have to do? We have to double this eighth even number we have to find out. What I said? Sorry. So, P is what I told you, odd number. And I have to find out 8th even number from this. So P is odd number. So add them 8th even number I have to find out. So P plus 8th double is 16. its double is 16. And if here odd and even is there, you have to subtract one from this. Subtract one from this. So how it is their answer? P and 15 minus 1 is equals to 16 minus 1 is equals to 15. So P plus 15 is its answer. Okay. Instead of this, if they are asking to you here 7. So 7th even number, suppose we have to find out. So 7th even number, how you will find? 7th double is 14. 7th double is 14. And 14 minus 1 is equals to 13. In that way, we have to find out its answer. Suppose one more question here, odd and even. Different is there, that which number they are asking, it's double, we have to do and do the subtraction. Previous number they are asking. So next we have find. Here, instead of finding the which is the next 7th even number, instead of it, if previous even number is there, at that time what we have to do? First of all, we have to do the addition. Do this process same, this, and after that this sign will be which? The negative sign will come. So which is the number will come here? So here P is a odd number and we have to find out 7th even, previous even number. Previous, I am speaking about previous even number. P is odd number. So P, previous number, then you have to do the subtraction. Which number they are asking? 7. 7 is double 14 and 14 minus 1 is equals to 14 minus 1 is equal to P minus 13 is the which number? That is the previous number. In that way we have to solve this example. Now we will see the next question. Which is the 5th odd number after 24? So 24 is here. First of all, tell me 24 is which number? It is even number. It is which number? Even number. So even number it is there, then at that time what we have to do? First of all, we have to even number is there and we have to find out odd number. Which is that number we have to find out? 5th odd number we have to find out. So just now I told you 24 first, right? Instead of pip, here 24 is given. 5th, 5th double 10. Okay, 5th double 10 and we have to do the subtraction. 1 we have to subtract from this. So here which number will be there? 24 and 10 minus 1 is the 9 and 24 plus 9 is equals to 33. Understood how to use this? Okay, so 24 is even number. So first of all, given number is even or odd, that we have to find out at first. And after that, what we have to do? Which number they are asking? That number's double we have to do. If even odd is there, directly that double minus 1, and if the odd odd or even even is there, only do the double. 5th double is 10 and 10 directly add to the 24th. So in that way you have to solve the question. Understood all of you? We will see the next question. Question number 3. So what is the question? Which is the third consecutive even number? Which is the third consecutive even number preceding 15? Preceding 15. The first of all, you must know the meaning of this word preceding. Preceding means what? Before number. Okay, and succeeding means what? After number. Preceding, before number. Here we have to take, find out the before number. And succeeded number means which we have to find out? The next number we have to find out. So this, if you understand the meaning of preceding and succeeding number, then you will easily find, first of all, third consecutive even number we have to find out, which is third consecutive even number. First of all, 15 is which number? Odd number. Okay, and which we have to find out? Third even number we have to find out, but that is also preceding even number. Means it's a, we have to, what we have to do? First write the 15. Yes, then preceding is there, that's why do directly write the subtraction sign. Then here 3. 3 is double, we have to do 6. And we have to, here odd is there and here even is there. Odd even, what I told you, double minus 1. So 3 is double is 6 and 6 minus 1 is equal to 5. So here 10 and 10, 6 minus 1 is equal to 5 and 10 minus 5 is equals to 5. So this is 10 minus 5 is equals to 10. So that is its answer. Understood what I told you? You have to use the rule what I told you. Even odd, double minus 1, even even, double, odd odd, double, even odd, and double minus 1. Preceding, you have to do the subtraction. Succeeding, you have to do the addition. Next number, addition. Before number, you have to do the subtraction. Understood? Now the next question. What is the sum of all odd numbers from 1 to 20? What is the sum of all odd numbers from 1 to 20? So if such a type of question will come in the exam, then if you will start what a odd number. So 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, then 11. If you started to do the addition of these all numbers, then it is difficult for you to complete the paper in time. Okay, because see here how much long chain it is there. And plus 19. These all numbers, if you do the addition, then you will get the answer of this question. But I will tell you one small trick of it. Okay, what they are asking to us? Odd number they are asking to us from 1 to 20. So at that time, if they are asking what is the sum of odd numbers from 1 to 20, so here I written some numbers. If you see here, which is the smallest number, smallest odd number from 1 to 20? It is 1. It is 1. And the largest odd number is which is there? 19 is there. Okay, is 19 is there. Sum of all number odd numbers from 1 to 20. Yes. So what we have to do at first? So here, if you see here, how many total odd numbers are there in between 1 to 20? As you know that if numbers are 20, so that addition is difficult for you. If 20 numbers are there, just now I told you, from that 20, 10 are odd and 10 are even. If they are asking to us, what is the sum of all odd numbers from 1 to 20? So how many odd numbers are there in the 1 to 20 inside? 10 odd numbers are there. So 10 odd numbers are there. You just do the square of 10, you will get its answer, 10 square. And if you try, if you do the addition and just check it, 1 plus 2, 2. 2 plus 6 means this addition, if you'll do, you will notice that its answer is also 100. So what we had done, suppose they are asking what is the sum of odd numbers from 1 to 50. So 1 to 15 said how many total odd numbers are there? 25 odd numbers are there. And you just do the 25 square, it is 625 is the sum of all odd numbers from the 1 to 50. Such a type of questions are also coming in the exam. But if this question is related to the which starting with the 1 to 20, at that time this is the correct method for it. Okay, but if they are asking the method what is the sum of numbers from 10 to 20, okay, so what is the sum question, how it is the question, what is the sum of all odd numbers from 11 to 20. So at that time what we have to do, first of all we have to just which is the smallest odd number 10 to 20 we are speaking, which is the smallest odd number from 1 to 20, that is 11, and greatest odd number 20 is the even number, so greatest odd number is 19. What I said, first number and last numbers we have to, first odd number and last odd numbers addition we have to do, and we have to subtract with the 2. Okay, so if your 11 plus 19 is equal to how much? It is 30. Okay. And 30 upon 2. Its answer is 15. Okay. And total 10 to 20 inside how many numbers are there? It's half. How many 11 numbers are there here? Odd numbers? 5. So you just multiply here with the 5. So first number is 11. Last number is 19. Divide it with 2. And how many total numbers are there? That you just multiply. You will get its answer. And its answer is, it's a here 19 plus 11 is equals to 30, and 30 upon 2 into 5. So 2 ones are 2, 15, and 15 5s are 75. 75 is the sum of all odd numbers from starting from 10 to 20. Understand? In this way we have to find. Suppose one more example I will take. What is the sum of all odd numbers from 20 to, suppose we are taking example of 50. So first of all, which is the smallest odd number? From this 20 to 20, 50, that is 20, next number is 21, and greatest is 49, divided with the 2 and multiply. If you see here, how many total numbers are there? 20 onwards, here till 50, that is in this 20 to 50 inside, total 15 numbers are there. Those are how many? Those are odd. So here, do the addition of this both, you will get answer here. 49 plus 1 20 is equal to 49 plus 1 50, 50 plus 20 is equal to 70. 70 upon 2 into 5, so 2 ones are 2, and here 35, okay, 35 5s are 5 5 is 25, 2 carry, 5 3 is 15 plus 2, 16 70. So 175 is its answer. So in this way you have to solve these types of questions. Understood all of you? Okay, we will see the next question now. The next question is the, what is the sum of two consecutive odd numbers x? Then what will be the number? So question is, the sum of two consecutive odd number is x, then what will be the, here that question is little bit wrong is there. So here it is the, what will be, what will one of the number be is the question. So first of all, if such a type of question will come in the exam, okay, if I will take you one example, if I will take the two consecutive odd numbers, so 7 and 5 I had taken here, okay, 7 and 5, 5 and 7. So what I have to find out, the sum of consecutive two odd number is x. These two sum is, suppose what is the sum of it? 12 is there. Then what is the one of the number? So how to find it? From 12, how to find this number? So first of all, divide it with the 2. Its sum you just divide with the 2. So 2 ones are 2. And 6 is 18, and from this 6 if you subtract 1 you will get the smallest number, and from this if you add 1 you will get the greatest number. So in this way we have to solve this example. What I told you, what is sum is given, how much sum is given, x is sum given. You just divide x with the with 2, okay, you just divide x with the 2, and then what we have to do, we have to add 1 from this. So here x divided by 2 plus 1, if you will do it, will get the odd number, next number, sorry, you will get the which number, next odd number. And if you divide this bracket inside, Bodomas rule we have to follow for this. So here x divided by 2 divided by 2 minus 1, then you will get the next even previous number of the of it. So in this way we have to find its answer. Here in the question there is a little bit correction is there, here we have to do the divisions sign, because here correction is there, this is wrong. So in this way we are solving the questions based on the even and odd numbers, and based on it some questions also we solve today. So from on based on this, today you will get the today's paper. So you just complete it properly and just refer all the rules that I told you today. So okay, so have a good day, and today we will stop here only. Okay, thank you.